Welcome to this video tutorial, one of many in a series designed to get you up and running with Leapfrog. This is video part 3 of 4 discussing drill hole data in Leapfrog. In this video, I'm going to cover color maps for displaying your drill hole data.
In parts 1 and 2, I left off with the project into which I had just imported a set of drill holes and fixed the errors. I briefly talked about how to edit the colors for the different units down the drill hole trace, but in this tutorial, I'll expand on that topic. There are two different color maps available in Leapfrog, discrete and continuous. Discrete color maps are used for coloring discrete data, which is data that can only take certain values. For example, geology data is always colored using a discrete color map because the values are different rock types. Discrete color maps can also be made to display grade data, which has been split into bins. For example, assay data could be visualized in bins with different colors for values between 0.75 and 1, 1 to 1.25, etc. We'll see an example of that later on in this tutorial. Continuous color maps are used for coloring continuous data, which is data that can take any value within a range. For example, grade data is colored using a continuous color map by default because the data can be any value between a minimum and a maximum value. In this example, we have used a contaminant value which has been measured in 14 out of the 44 holes. First, we'll talk about discrete color maps. As we've seen already, when a drill hole table is being viewed in the scene, there are two boxes that allow you to edit visualization options. The box on the left lets you choose what you want to view, and the box on the right lets you choose how you want to view it. In this case, I'm going to ensure I'm viewing the simple lith column of data and then click Edit Colors. To edit the color of the GND, I'll click the color swatch. In the color selecting window, there are a number of different methods for choosing a color, including the color wheel, the RGB value, or the HSV value, the color palette, the color picker, and the random color generator. Most of these options are pretty self-explanatory. For the RGB and the HSV values, simply enter the desired numbers. To use the color ring, choose the color by dragging the small white bar around the ring, and then drag the small circle around the triangle to choose the shade of color. To select a color from the palette, simply click the swatch. These colors were selected for the palette as they provide good contrast with each other. In addition to these options, we also offer the color picker, which is the little eyedropper seen right here. This is useful if you've imported a geological map and would like the colors for your drilling or your geological model to be the same as the colors for the map. To use the color picker, click the icon and then click on any item in the screen. If you have colors in another software package that you would like to use in Leapfrog, just make sure the two softwares are open on the same screen, click the eyedropper, and then click anywhere in the other software package. Lastly, if you feel like a little excitement in your color selecting, you can use the random color generator located near the bottom of the window. Now that we've covered discrete color maps, let's take a look at continuous color maps. I'll clear the screen and drag in the contamination table. To edit the color maps, click the second drop-down, Edit Color Maps. By default, it will be the blue, green, yellow, red color map. However, there are other options you can choose from in the gradient drop-down. You can also choose to invert the color map by simply ticking Invert. For a continuous color map, values which lie below the minimum limit or above the maximum limit will be colored using the color at either end of the color map. The limits for the colors can be selected here. By default, the dynamic is selected and limits the color range from 0 to 2 in this example. However, if I'd like to see the colors for the input data range, I can simply select that. Now the range is between 0 and 4. The way in which the colors change based on the values can be edited by moving the two dots around the graph. The horizontal axis defines the values at which the various colors will appear, and the vertical axis defines the colors that the different values will be displayed as. If you'd like to revert back to the original settings, simply select Revert All. It is also possible to create a discrete color map from continuous numeric data by splitting it into discrete bins. I'll start by selecting Discrete Colourmap Create. Click the Add button to add extra bins to the color map. You can then change the values in the Max column, and the Min column will be updated accordingly. You can change the range by toggling this less than and equal to sign to being a less than sign. The appropriate change will also be made to the greater than sign. Color maps can be imported and exported from Leapfrog. If your organization uses standard color coding for numeric and categorical data, you can import and export color maps between projects to save time setting the colors up. This is particularly useful if your company has a specific color scheme that is consistent across different projects. To import or export a color map, simply right-click on the column of interest, Colors, Import or Export. Leapfrog generates an LFC file that can be shared between projects.